White line is the lifeline to a nation. And men like Will and Sonny make it move. A good hot cup of coffee is waiting up ahead, and the rhythm of the highway hums along. Jamming gears has got to be a fever, 'cause men become addicted to the grind. It takes a special breed to be a truck driving man, and a steady hand to pull that load behind. Big wheels rolling, gotta keep them going. Big wheels rolling, moving on.
We ought to make plans for tonight.
What do you have in mind?
I don't know.
Dinah Randall?
I hear she got married.
I think it's off. I'm going to call Terry.
Hey, that's a good idea. She's got that friend Lucille. Hey, I'd really go for her.
I remember Lucille. For a lady her age, she seems to be in remarkable condition.
What do you mean, her age?
You know what I mean. You really like her, huh?
You know, the thing I like about Lucille is you can talk to her. She's not just a body. She's probably the smartest girl in the whole state of Oregon.
Yeah. I know what you mean.
Exactly.
Do you?
Absolutely.
What do you talk about?
Oh, you'd be surprised.
Well, surprise me.
Well, I guess mostly we talk about sex.
That guy is some kind of weird.
Maybe he didn't see us.
I think I'll let you and Lucille go to the seminar, and I'll find somebody who isn't quite so interested in talking. All right?
Well, he's gotta be kidding.
In Rome.
Thanks for the tip. Uh-oh. You okay?
No, I ain't okay. Look at my truck. Look at me. You guys in them big fancy rigs, you think you own the whole road.
Now listen, Buster.
Look at it. Look at my truck. Look at my load.
You're lucky to be alive.
You lousy hot shot.
He's really hot.
Better take him to the hospital.
These little guys in their little trucks.
Probably hit his head when the truck turned over.
Let's go. Well, remind me never to tangle with you. Where's the doc? We gotta get going.
This is really something.
What's so interesting?
Call the book. It might do you some good. It's about mankind, about...
You know what we're doing, where we're going. Reading's so bad for the eyes, and I already know where we're going. We're going to Portland.
Mr. Pruitt. And you must be Mr. Chandler.
How's the patient?
He's in trouble.
What's the problem? Concussion, right?
We took some blood tests. It's a normal admitting procedure. It's cancer. and it's metastasized through the entire lymphatic system.
What does it mean? How long has he got?
A month. Two, maybe.
What the hell's he doing driving a truck?
He still doesn't know what he has.
You didn't tell him?
No.
Well, somebody's got to tell him. He's got to wonder why you're keeping him here.
Are you close friends?
Oh, no.
I don't even know his name. Well, he drove off the road and we were there. That's all.
And his name is Shannon. Joseph Shannon. He's from Seaside.
Doctor?
What is it, Ferris?
It's Mr. Shannon. He's gone. I don't know how. He must have just put his clothes on and...
Can you get him back here?
We don't know him.
Probably on his way back to his truck.
We might be passing him, but that's no guarantee we can persuade him to come back to the hospital.
Yeah, but we take tests, we can make what time he has left a little easier.
Oh, what a bummer.
Yeah. A lot of things he's never gonna do.
Month. Maybe two. As my old man used to say, he's almost through the book. You know, if it was me, I would have me the time of my life. I'd squeeze it all in.
Yeah? What would you do?
What would I do?
Yeah, what'd you do?
Well, there's a gal I met in L.A. once. I just talked to her for a minute. I'd call her up. And I haven't been to New Orleans for a while. And I'd get me to Boston and grab me a 4-pound lobster.
You just had a lobster in Seattle. That's for women. You're doing all right. You're doing fine. Is that all you ever think about?
What would you do, college man?
Watch it. Watch it.
Shape.
Yeah, I wonder why. Snap it up.
It'll probably take you 3 or 4 days to get your truck fixed.
There's not much left to fix.
Yeah, you really screwed it up for me.
Well, it's in the garage. You could check back into the hospital.
The hospital? You out of your mind?
Just to be sure. You passed out.
Listen, I got a load to get to Portland. I would have been there now, except it wasn't you guys and your fancy rig.
Look, get this straight. We didn't do anything wrong. If you hadn't
been... Okay, okay.
Lighten up. Shannon, we don't blame you for being upset. I mean, there's your truck and your load all over the place, and we're very sympathetic.
Where are you guys going?
Portland.
Oh, take my load.
Why?
You know, I know my rights. I could sue you guys.
All right, we're empty. We'll deliver your load for you, no charge. But you got to go back to the hospital. Doc says he's got to take some more tests, and that was really stupid, running out like that. Doc says you could have hurt yourself.
No way. I ain't paying for no doctor's big car.
Makes sense. What if you're sick?
Sick? I ain't never been sick a day in my life. My grandfather was 85 years old. He died with his boots on. My father, 65 years old. He worked 7 days a week. Come on, let's get the spuds in the truck.
Okay, we'll deliver your load, but you got to get back to the hospital.
No way. I ain't trusting my load with you guys. I'm coming with you.
You know something? If he was healthy, he wouldn't live long.
Chives, tomatoes, and
Blueberry pie.
Oh, yeah, same for me, except I'll take apple pie.
How about you?
2 fried eggs, over easy, and a glass of milk.
Do you want potatoes with your egg?
Does that come with it?
No.
No potatoes. Clip joint. $1.20 for 2 fried eggs.
Excuse me.
I got no time for women.
Family?
My mother died when I was 3.
And your father's alive.
Yeah.
I mean, you said that.
Yeah.
Here we go. Thank you. Thanks, love.
I didn't order no roast beef.
But he...
It's on me.
2 fried eggs. Over easy.
Take it for a while, will you, Will? I'm going to get some sack time.
Guys like those cab overs, you know? I like these conventions.
You like it, huh?
I guess you saved and saved and saved till you could afford it.
Not mine. Sonny's. And the bank. You ever drive one of these?
I took a course once. Drove her for 2 weeks.
Think you can handle it?
Good as you can.
Well, at least you're consistent.
That's some kind of crack?
No crack. Hey, you want to take the wheel?
Sure, I'd be glad to help you out.
You smiling, Shannon?
No.
How does it feel?
Feels like a...
Come on.
Like a...
Come on.
Like a truck. Wow. 15 forward speed, citizen band radio, turbocharger, air conditioning. I'm gonna get me one of these.
Check the tires, brakes, air compressor valves.
Fifth wheel?
The works.
Right.
Let's check in, okay?
Okay. Shannon?
I ain't going to no motel.
Clean. We stay there.
I got better things to do with my money. I sleep in the rig.
It's okay with me.
But I won't eat in the rig.
See, the thing is, we got dates.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Look, Shannon, if you need some bread for the motel...
I don't need no money. Because I don't spend it foolishly. Have a good time. Have a good time.
Well, maybe we could... Oh, forget it.
Girls would love that.
I said forget it.
Well, I could make a phone call.
And fix him up. You know any girl that hard up?
Guess he'd never sit still for it. Unless she'd agree to order nothing but fried eggs.
Over easy. You know, if he would sit still, Foot, who would you call?
Myrna Powell.
Oh, that sweet thing.
Maybe that's what he needs, a sweet thing. Shannon.
Hi. I know this is asking a lot, but could you do me a favor?
What kind of favor?
We got an extra girl.
Oh, no.
She's very nice.
I say.
She's very pretty. I'd appreciate it.
New days. Bag.
You know something about Mr. Shannon? He's just a half a bubble off plumb.
Well, he's going to have a good time if it's the last thing I do. Call Myrna. I'm going to take Shannon for a walk.
What about the hospital?
First things first. Shannon! Having a good time?
It's okay.
Wild enthusiasm. Hey, didn't you grow up here? That's right. Your father still lives here.
Near here.
Well, would you like to take some time off and go see him?
He don't want to see me, and I don't want to see him.
Shannon, would you like a little target practice?
That's the rep. I paid my own way.
Oh. Okay. Hey, that's terrific. Who taught you to shoot like that?
From the farm.
Excuse me. I think I see some possible friends. How you doing?
Despair.
Would you mind if I gave you a few pointers? With the rifle, you have to hold it very tightly. That's it. Pull it in. Now, the trigger. Don't just pull it. You have to squeeze very slow.
Okay, I think I got
it. Oh, it's just the first time. Maybe you just need practice.
I guess I do. But you don't.
I'll try it again.
All right.
Okay. Now just squeeze. Oh, yeah, that's better. Now just squeeze slow. Yeah, now you're getting it. Yeah, that's it. Now just squeeze slow.
Okay, let me show you how to do this.
I'll see you later. Shannon! Hey, Shannon,
don't
come with me.
I knew I never should have tried it. You see the dirty look she gave me?
She didn't give you a dirty look. I've been meaning to tell you. I mean, it's your clothes, man. When did you get them? When Eisenhower was president?
Nobody ever complained before.
Well, maybe you never... Come on, let's get you some new clothes.
I ain't got no money for clothes.
Come on.
Why'd you get it?
I don't wear hats.
Come on.
Gentlemen, can I help you?
Yeah, my friend is looking for an outfit.
May I suggest the junior department?
Junior department, huh? You cheap punk. I could take you on any time.
Easy, Jonah. You didn't mean anything by that.
No? Junior department. That's children's department.
The junior department just means that it's different sizes, right?
Right. Even the mayor shops at the junior department.
I ain't the mayor.
Such a dude.
You guys still got that date?
Yeah. Name is Myrna. She's terrific.
Where we gotta take her?
Well, nothing fancy, just a few beers, a little bowling.
Big Eater? No. You guys did me a favor. I'm gonna do you guys a favor.
I'm gonna hide it.
Come on, Joe. How many girls have you really known?
All right, more you can shake a stick at.
Anyway, Joe, I have the feeling that I've seen you before. Did you go to Willard High?
Yeah. Oh, but probably a long time after you were here.
If I said that, you'd have walked out on me.
If you'd have said it, you'd have meant it.
Stealing my girl. That's the thanks I get.
I'd like to steal him. Mm-hmm.
Oh, hey, Will. Hey, Will, I wouldn't steal your date on you. I really wouldn't muster on you.
That's all right. You can't help it if you're irresistible. Right, Lucille?
Right.
How are you?
All right, Will.
You look sensational. Forgot how tall you are.
Well, last time you said I was just about right.
You were. You are.
Well, I hope you're grateful. I broke a date with a guy who's got a very nasty temper.
Well, I appreciate the favor.
Favor?
Well, something I ought to tell you. There's a friend of mine.
What?
A friend of mine. You're really going to like him.
Friend of yours?
Yeah.
For me?
Yeah.
I went and lied to a guy with a very nasty temper for
really
a friend of yours?
It.
Oh, you've got a lot of nerve.
He's kind of a shy little guy.
Forget it.
You're going to like him.
That is a dirty thing to pull.
It's important.
How?
I wouldn't ask anybody else.
All right, Will. I gotta be crazy.
Paul, Terry,
hi.
Lucille,
hi.
And Joe Shannon.
Just don't say I'm too tall.
Just don't say I'm too short.
Agreed.
Oh, can I buy you something to drink?
Yeah, a glass of wine, maybe.
How about champagne?
Oh, I'd love some.
Well, I know it's going to cost $6, but you only live once, right, Myrna?
Yeah, right, Joe.
Hey, that's super, super.
That was terrific.
Let me show you how.
Oh, yeah, sure. Oh, wait a minute. Let me take off these dumb heels so I don't trip over them.
You're not that tall.
You're not that short.
Crack.
Got all the time in the world.
Come on, Myrna.
I'm Mervyn.
You said your mother was sick.
She suddenly got to feeling better.
Well, then there's no reason we can't have our date.
Hey, wait a minute, mister. She don't want to go, she don't have to go.
Gentlemen. Gentlemen. Take it easy.
Take it easy. I could take that punk and the two punks with me.
Come on, Shannon. We don't want to fight.
What's the matter? Is he afraid?
Well, I don't know about him, but I am.
I never like fights.
It's not just because of his slip disc. Neither of us likes to fight.
Well, he's so big and strong. I think it's time for us to run away. Gentlemen, I'm sure we can talk this over at that. Hey, lay off, you guys. Take it easy. You don't want to hurt anybody.
Now, come on, fellas. Why make trouble?
Watch it. Now, back off, will you?
We're the new breed of trucker. Quiet, refined, polite.
And chicken.
Hey, it's the cops. Get
cops!
Out.
Let's get out of here.
Hey, guys.
I've never been a coward before in my life, and I love it.
That calls for more champagne.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
Look at this rig. What is it with you guys? You haven't done a thing.
Tune-up will be finished in a minute.
Anybody could do a tune-up. This here vehicle costs $40,000. Look at it. It's filthy. I'm going to pass the word along. You want a pigsty on the road, this here is the place to bring your rig.
Look, I'm sorry. I thought one of the other guys had... I'll get on it right away.
It's all right. Nobody's perfect.
Good morning, Shannon.
Oh, hi. Just checking up.
Get Myrna home safely?
How about some breakfast?
Well, as a matter of fact, I already had breakfast, so maybe I'll just stay in the rain.
Yesterday, that little guy went through a complete metamorphosis.
You always said that Myrna is a miracle worker.
Yeah, I bet she is, but I keep wondering if it's her or the truck. I mean, he's talking as if it was his truck, not ours.
What do you mean, ours? That's my truck.
Well, all right, if you want to be technical.
Technical? That truck was mine a long time before I ever met you. What do you come off technical?
Don't get in an uproar.
Not getting in an uproar.
Why don't we?
No.
Just a piece.
A piece of my truck?
Right, if you want to put it that way.
Do you know any other way to put it? My truck.
How long has the poor guy got?
Oh, now, come on. Don't do that to me. I am not going to give him a piece of my rig.
Okay.
Look, he's no dummy. What would we say to him?
Okay,
you know, you are so beautiful and you stripped you so terrifically that we're going to give you a piece of the rig.
Okay. You're right. I mean, he wouldn't believe it.
You bet your sweet life he wouldn't believe it. You try that, the first thing he's going to wonder is why we're being so nice to him.
Absolutely right. It's impossible. Forget it.
Of course, if we didn't just give him a piece.
Sonny. What do you mean?
You know what he's doing?
Yeah. He's getting nervous.
No. We owe him $50 already, and he feels so bad about it, he's throwing the game so we can win it back. That's what he's doing.
Maybe you're right. You, give me a sawbuck.
You kidding?
Can you get the number of the stick?
Sure, I can do that. Which one?
The little guy. Check shirt and pants.
Oh, the shrimp? Yeah, I can make it look good.
Six.
Chandler, 26, 41, and 28.
Oh, man.
Beautiful. I've never been to sleep.
You are some hot hurler, man.
Okay, doctor, what's the bad news?
It is 9. Well, the way I figure, we owe him $900. $400 from you, $500 from me.
Well, I feel rotten about this. But, hey, can we go back in there and I'll play you for double or nothing?
No, we played double or nothing 5 times already. You won each time, not me. I know when I'm licked.
I can't take no $900 from friends.
That's good, because I ain't got it.
Well, I got 90 in cash.
How much?
80.
Now, forget it.
Forget it? Look, I wasn't raised that way.
Sonny, how are we going to pay $900 in cash?
Forget it. I don't really want it.
All right. Owe you $900. We can't pay you. Would you... would you take a piece of the rig for it?
You mean you make me a partner in your rig?
I know, it sounds like we're taking advantage, but how else are we going to pay this debt?
I'd be a partner.
But I know the cash is better, our work's harder. You don't need that kind of hassle.
I'd be a partner?
Look, the fact is, I could use a third man. I work very hard, but Will doesn't even pull his share.
Well, yes, he does, son. Try.
Well, then help him. What do you say, Sean?
Good. How's it feel?
The day you run my rig, day I run my rig off the road is perhaps the luckiest day of my life. Hey, can we bring this rig to show somebody?
I don't mind. Sonny?
I don't mind. Myrna, huh?
Nah.
Who? Some of your old buddies around town?
Got no buddies. Never had no buddies before.
Thank you.
That's mine. That's my rig. You see, Pop? Jay Shannon. My truck. I told you.
Yeah. You told me.
Up in the motel and take off.
Yeah, we gotta get to Portland. Unless you wanna go to Myrna.
Will, pull over. How you feeling?
Okay, I guess. Got sort of a pain. Did I pass out?
Joe, let's take you to a doctor just in case.
You guys been trying to get me to a doctor practically since the first time I saw it.
Well, you got shook up when your truck turned over.
You passed out, man. The doctor said you had no business leaving the hospital like that.
Okay, what about this doctor? What'd he tell you?
You need some more tests.
Tests? What kind of tests? He took tests. What'd he tell you? He tell you that I told him that I've been feeling kind of wiped out the past few months? Come on, tell me. What'd I pass out? What?
Joe, you gotta go to the hospital.
Why, damn it? Why do I have to go to the hospital?
You're sick, man. You're really sick.
What is it?
Cancer.
What? How bad is it?
It's pretty bad.
That bad? Did they tell you? Did they tell you how long I got?
Maybe a few months.
Look. If you go to the hospital, maybe they can help you.
Sure. I should have figured. I said to myself, why are these guys being so nice to me? Helping me with my load. Let me drive the rig. Let me win a share in the rig. You had that all arranged, didn't you? I mean, anybody in their right mind wouldn't bet their truck in a bowling alley. All those good times. Dressing me up in Myrna. You had that all fixed because you felt sorry for me.
Myrna really likes you, Joe.
All phony. Let me tell you something. I got along without you guys or anybody before I met you, and I still get along. You can take your rig and shove it up the road.
He's not in his room.
Check out?
Nobody's seen him. Did you get in touch with Myrna?
Hasn't heard from him.
Well, maybe went back to see his old man.
But you?
No, I guess not.
You know, I never figured him as the kind of guy who would split. I figured him as the kind of guy who would die with his boots on, deliver that last load. Well,
maybe we should have told him right at the beginning before we got so buddy-buddy.
I think we get buddy-buddy with a guy like that.
I hope we haven't made it worse.
You know, it must have been something growing up with him.
I gotta do.
Joe, why don't you let us drop you off at a hospital? We'll take care of your load.
Well, Sonny, all I got left is a couple of months. I wanted to be like, well, like last couple of days. I want to be with my friends. Never had no friends. And with you guys, I've had the time of my life. You know what I mean? Look. Let me stay with you. I'll do my share. And when it gets bad and I can't handle it, I'll tell you. Then you can drop me off at the hospital. But now I'll carry my weight. That's a promise. Just let me enjoy myself.
Okay.
You ain't never gonna change.
Just all his worldly goods.
Pretty fancy, huh? Ain't much. Just my share of the rig, it's yours. Hey, what are we gonna do in Portland when we get rid of this load?
Well, I know this really terrific little bowling alley.
Yeah, I know a place where we can get some roast beef, that thing.
Yeah?
Yeah. What's
the matter? Well, you wouldn't have no a girl in Portland. Ha, 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 ha.